Mock paper flowers in a canal bucket. To trace the spider mites, we must peel the rind of calendar spots and let cocked babbling tubules of the storm rinse away uncomfort. But we seem to be outside the ice-tinseled shallows of the rinse, laughing at rude green spears in the drain mouth. And the mock paper flowers run with us up the breezy Jack and Jill, down the brick cellar of unbroken distance, trailing their spider mites and bending with stitch, the taste of black lung on the whiskers of a ghost. Oh, we can roll noise up in its silent linings and tread near the unexploded houses. We can belly inch the nettle smoke to look upon canal buckets rusted through the scribbles of red ochre. But thriving in there cannot be seen. The spider mites have become enlarged, joining a few splinters from the ruins to make a dining hall. And there they sit, napkin, knife and fork in monstrous silhouette, just beyond the periphery of sight. Mock paper flowers in a canal bucket. Where are the spider mites?